So I'll just finishing of the application level events today. You find the session. Now it takes around 1.5 hours for you to fix up the example. First one, what is this application level event? In the last session, component level events. Now, with respect to the discussion what we had in the last 20 minutes, sir, the purpose of events is, now listen to the point. It is not necessary that if you are building entire application from your end, you can write like a single component, no problem. Now question is, already if component is already existing, why you want to write it again? Then only I'll use the existing component, no? You need to understand, if you are building the code, and as per your requirement, you feel that this particular functionality is required in 2 or 3 components, then only I will define that functionality as a separate component. Otherwise, why would I divide the same functionality into 3 different components? Why I want to divide it? What's my point? When the component, when the functionality in the component is very big, we want to improvise the loading time, and we assume that this type of functionality is required in multiple contexts. Then only I am going to break the component into number of subcomponents. Or the number of events are more, like on click, on function, like functionality wise it's more. Then only I will try to apply the multiple components, right? So the reason is if the length of the program is, if length of the program is more and they are independent, instead of building as a one, I will try to build as a multiple, so the load time will be different. Now it's a simple example. Now there are 2 functionalities you have got in the Visual Force page. Apex page, controller equal to Apex class, action equal to, right? Why you are taking action? You might write that code in the constructor only, no? We write, we have a functionality called Apex. We have a functionality called Apex page, controller equal to example, action equal to. Now why are you putting controller equal to example, action equal to show? Whatever you wrote in the show, I can put in the controller only, no? I can put in the constructor itself, right? Now, after running the class, it will call show. Now, we want some action to be performed before the actual logic performs. Then why don't you put that action also in the example? Now, why are you putting like a controller action? We want to reduce the load time. If you put everything in the constructor, installation, every work, then what happened? Constructor will execute. It takes more time for the running the constructor. So I'm breaking the work. Boss, first you load the page. You run the constructor, then we'll run the action. We are breaking the work. We are trying to improvise the performance of the page. Similarly, when you are trying to achieve this functionality, let us say, you have taken this account. Now can't I write, build all this functionality in a single component? Can't I build? Why don't I build? I can happily do it, but lot of CSS I have to write, lot of breaking I have to give, elements I have to give, right? That is the reason what we are doing. We are building this as one separate component. We are building this as separate component. We are giving this as a separate component. We are building as this separate component. Because if I run all these things as a single component, it takes more time for loading. And there is a possibility for me that this type of functionality I'll be keep using in multiple objects. The same type of functionality I'll be using in multiple objects. In every object, when I click on the record, record data should be displayed here. The same type of functionality I'm using a number of times. Why should I write as a separate? Okay. Why should I write this code within a component? Let me write this as a separate component so that I can use the same component in multiple contexts. Now you are looking at one example like this working. Now you are a developer who need to look at the broad scale. Are getting my point here? Now you are simply building one example, so you are not able to understand why we are breaking into components. Now the scope of this functionality, according to your functionality, what is the scope of this particular action to be used? How frequently we are going to use this type of structure? We need to analyze that. Based on that, we go for a components. Right? Now you are looking at it. Now we are not building an application here. What we are building is a particular example. One context functional requirement we are taking and building it. With respect to that functional component, when you are building it, when the functionality is big, why I want to build everything in a single one? I want to go for a reusability. What is the, okay, I want to go for reusability. Why you want to go for reusability? To reduce the burden, right? Now this type of functionality I frequently use. What is that? New task, log a file, log a call, new event, mail. This functionality I am going to use in every object. When I am going to use on every object, why you want to write separately for every component? Let me build as a independent component. Use them within the functionality. I hope you are good with this. I hope you are good with this. You got the story? You got the story? Now if you are building like this, you need to understand the overall picture of the story. Then if you feel that this functionality is going to take more time, if you feel that this is a reusable entity, then we are going to define it as a separate component. When you define it as a separate component, then we go for events to exchange the information. If you are building entire thing like a single component, events are not required. No need of component level event, no need of application level events. Right? Are you getting my point? Because I have built some component which is taking more time, I want to break them and run it. I want to break them and run it. Let us say, now I have given an option. If I click on activity, if I click on new task, if I click on new task, creation of task page is coming. Do you know what I am going to click? Okay, when I click on a log a call, we are getting this structure. New event, email. Now what is my context? I don't want to load everything, boss. I don't want to load everything. I want to load that particular component only when I click on this. Are you getting my point? Now, if I want to build this, this component itself will take a lot of time. Are you getting? So, we are trying to break the bigger functionality, number of small reusable entities, so that the load time will be reduced and the scope of reusability is more. The scope of reusability is more. Right, because every component will have its own handler, every component is going to have its own independent functionality. So all of them are going to run independently. As all of them are running independently, when you load, performance will be faster. If you take everything as a single component, then whatever the initialization I have to do in the single handler. So it takes more time. So the basic objective is wherever there is a possibility, break them as independent component, run it so that there is a more scope of reusability of the core, more scope of functionality. When you are going for such type of thing, then I will use the events to exchange the information. Now, is it necessary that I have to go for event? Depends upon the context. We cannot give a global definition. Now, wherever there is a scope, break the functionality into number of independent components. So, your logic is to break the component into number of subtasks to improvise the pace. So, depends upon the context will come. We cannot give a global definition. In this example, I will use a component event. In this example, I will go for a single component. I cannot give that. So, wherever there is scope of breaking the functionality, you break it. Wherever this data should be exchanged, we can go for events. When you want the data to be exchanged. When you want the data to be exchanged. Last session, I gave an example like this. Some example I gave. Object, pick list fields, something I gave like that. If I'm right, I gave this type of structure, right? Choose the object, choose the fields, choose the object, choose the fields, right? Then show the data based on the fields. Now I can build everything in a single component. I can build everything in a single component. Nobody is going to obstruct you if you build a single component. But in the future, if you want to make any changes on this, then what should happen? The same component, if you want to make any changes in the future, again, what should happen? Entire code is recompiling. Right? So your objective should be making a small entities. So that usage will be quicker, modification will be easy. So you decide a call. Now, as per this, can I make the bigger functionality, smaller functionality. Wherever there is a scope, you decide it. If you build everything with a single component, nobody is going to beat you, boss. Right? You can build with a single component. Nobody is going to obstruct you. But now I am saying, boss, there is a concept of data table. Use this. There is a concept of data table. This concept I am going to use in multiple elements. Then why you are writing a code separately like this here? Put a new component created. Simply call that component here. So I can use it n number of locations. Right? So, if you break them into small entities and build it, now if you want a similar type of functionality, we can reuse it. That is the reason we are going for breaking into multiple components and using the events to exchange the information. I hope you are good with this. Good with this. Right? Right. Somebody in the beginning had a discussion. Right, Amma? Okay.
Yeah, Satish. Yeah. Satish, just one question extending to that. Is there any design pattern concepts in Lightning?
Everywhere, anywhere you use Apex, there will be a design pattern concept clause. Design pattern is not on the UI, it is on the control side. Will be there.
Okay, not on the UI. Okay.
Now come back to the story. I hope everyone is good with that. Okay. Let us move on to the story. Application level events. What are these application level events? Why we want to use it? Now look at a context. I have a parent component. I have a child component. Now, name. When I get the name, Wipro, I have a button here. When I enter the name called Wipro, click on a button. Then what should happen? It has to go to whatever the data entered here, the data should pass through. So data entered in one component should go to its siblings. Last week's session topic is what? When the data is entered in the subchain, parent, grandparent. Now what is my concept now? When I enter the data in one component, the data should be exchanged with other siblings. The data should be exchanged with other siblings. How this data is exchanged between siblings? Let us take. When I enter the account name, click on submit, I have to get data like this. List of contacts, list of projects. Initially, there are no contacts, there are no opportunities. Now, account, now look at the point. Listen to the context. Now, you will get a context here. When you enter the account name, this account may have contacts, may have opportunities. I cannot guarantee. Can you guarantee that there will be always a contacts and opportunities? No, I cannot guarantee. Now check if accounts are there, account contacts are there, display this. Only display this. Only contacts. If opportunities are there, display opportunities. Now what I'm doing? Now they're acting as two different. How you control? You can control using era if. Instead of controlling using era if, now I'm trying to define this as an independent component. Now I can write this code. I can write a code to display data table, code to display list of contacts, data table, code to display list of opportunity. Now what should I do? I have to write one data table to display list of contacts, another data table to display list of opportunities. Instead of this, if I write a generic concept called data table, hide this. Right? Now what will we do? We will define one list of contacts, another list of opportunities. Right? Now what I'm going to do? Use this. Boss, if it is available, display this component. Not available. If opportunities are available, contacts and opportunities. Are you getting my point? We are trying to break the functionality into number of sub-functionalities. Are you trying to get my context? So when I enter the account name, get the list of contacts, get the list of opportunities. Get the list of contacts, get the list of opportunities. There is no guarantee that contacts will be there. There is no guarantee that opportunities will be there. Now what I want to do, I want to make this code simple. I don't want to put everything at one location. Now you have a textbook, boss. You have notes. You are writing a notes in a book. Right? Now how much time it takes you to find out the various these component level events? Right? Open your books and tell me in which page you have component level events. From last 5-6 weeks or 4 weeks you are attending the classes, no? Open the page where is component level events. What will you do? Shuffle the pages. Now the same thing, you wrote one index page and you told first topic, second topic, page number, third topic, page number. Then what happened? By looking at index, all the things that are there in the textbook of 500 pages, whatever is there, I can look at the index and tell you. Now what is happening? The page contains some data, the page number and topic name is given. Right? Now what we are doing in the index? Topic name, page number, topic name, page number. Like this, we are making a parent component which contains number of individual components. Now I know what all the different components are running in this. I can go to every individual component and see what is there in this. Easy for me to understand what functionality is running. If I show you 1000 lines of code, obviously, okay, you find difficult to understand what is the functionality. Now, if I make these same 1000 codes independently, like 50 code one part, 50 code one part, 50 code one part. Now, when you look at that, it's easy for you to understand what this component is going to do. Am I right or wrong? Putting all the 1000 lines at one place or breaking them into 50, 50, 50 and showing you, easy for you to understand. That's what I'm trying to achieve in the components. We are trying to break the bigger functionality into number of small independent components, join them and achieve what is your requirement. When you break them into a number of independent components, how will the data exchange? If the data need to be exchanged between the siblings and your parent, siblings and your parent, then we go for application level event. Then we go for what? Application. When you say application level event, the data will be exchanged between the components. When an event is raised by you, your sibling can handle, multiple siblings can handle, your sibling can handle, multiple siblings can handle at a time, your parent can also handle. So when the event occurs on the first one, contact can handle, opportunity can handle, parent can also handle. This is called application level event. I hope you got the story. Am I clear with this? Okay. Now let us look at the basic definition part. I think we removed it. Okay. When I'm going for application level event, look at this. We don't need an example, just we need. Okay. So, now when it is an application event, event is fired. Event is fired. When an event is fired, your siblings can subscribe it. So, when you fire the event, whichever the components are subscribing, all of them will get notification. You fired, okay, you published it. When I publish it, whoever is subscribed, they get the notification. Like your Facebook, whoever is following you, automatically when you post, all of them will get. How many of them will get? Everyone who is following. Everyone who is following, automatically they get the list. Am I right or wrong? You publish a message, whoever is following, all of them will get it. So it is like publish and subscribe model. What was this? Publish and subscribe model. You publish your event, whoever is subscribing, they will get the access. Now, how do you create an application level event? Simple. When you want to create a component level event, you give your event type equal to component. If it is application level event, your event type equal to application. I hope you are good with this. Right, Emma? I hope you are good with this. Okay. Now, let me create the basic example first. Look at this new lightning event. Right. Now I'm giving event here. Type of event is application. Your event, type of event is application. Now, am I passing any data? Right now, I am not passing any data. I simply create an event. When event is created, if a component want to register, how does the component register? Your dot. Now I'm giving era or lighting. So when you click on the button, it is going to call C dot show. Then I'll give component. Tap event child one. I'll try to modify the structure slightly. In the child one, we have written this register an event. This is a child one. Child one register event. I am writing child two. So how many components we have here? 1, 2, 3. Child 1, child 2, child 3. So child 1, child 2, child 3. Here I am giving C dot. This is what I get. Child 1, child 2, child 3. Now all these are siblings or? Child 1, child 2, child 3. All the three are siblings. All the three are siblings. Right. Now, try to understand this. Now you have created an event. How do you fire an event? How do you fire an event? Then how to subscribe the event? If you want to fire an event, what we are used to do? Component dot get event name. Am I right? In the component level event, how did you give? Component dot get event event name. But in the application, we will not use this format. In the application level, what we do? Dollar a dot get dollar a dot get e dot c colon event name. Dollar a dot get e dot c colon app name. Now look at the point. So here we have example one. Example one show. Example one told show. When you click on show, what I was giving here, where event equal to dollar a dot get c dot what happened? E dot c colon event name, e dot c colon event name, event dot file, e dot c colon event name, event dot fire. So when you fired, what will happen? One has fired the event. Who has to handle it? Child 2, child 3 and a parent. Now child 1 fired, child 2, child 3 want to handle it. If you want to write a handler, how you define the handler? Yura handler name equal to name of the event, event. So in the component level event, name plays a major role. In the application level event, there is no importance to the name. So what I am going to do? Yura handler event equal to then we are giving here, your attribute name equal to my name, type equal to string. So what is the action we give? When you fire show, v dot, what is the name I give?
Satish, if in all the components we have to give the handler.
Obviously.
In application handler.
No. See, whoever want to handle, will give it. It's not mandatory that everybody is going to handle. Now my example is to demonstrate that more than one component can handle at a time. So I am giving handler for every component. It is not necessary that every component will handle it. My intention was to tell you that all the siblings can handle it. So I was giving this. This is a primary example to show that multiple elements can handle it. So what happened? Child 1 fired, child 2 handled, child 3 handled. Child 1 fired, 2 handled, 3 handled. 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 At the same time, even the parent can handle it. Even the parent can handle it. Who is the parent component? So now, all of who all are handling this? Who are handling this? One is firing, two is handling, three is handling. One is firing, two is handling, three is handling, parent is also handling. One fired, two is handling, three is handling, parent is also handling. You are not just doing an example, just it's to demonstrate who is going to handle it. Right. So let's move on to the story. Now we want to call an application. App event. What was that? App event. App event example. There are too many components here. I'll just do, let me remove one by one. Let me check. Okay. So this is how I give. Thank you. Go to the no, I am child 2, I am child 3, I am parent 1. I am child 2, I am child 3, I am parent 1. So when I clicked on this button, who is handling? Child 2 is handling, child 3 is handling, parent is also handling. So application level event means when an event occurs on one component, its siblings can handle, its parent can also handle. Can a child also can handle? Yes. Okay, parent can handle, siblings can handle, child can handle. Now everyone can handle this. When I say component level, your parent can handle, your child can handle, your siblings can handle. When I say application level event, your parent can handle, your child can handle, your siblings can handle. Your parent can handle, your child can handle, your siblings can handle. Are you getting my point? Clear for everyone? It is like a publish and subscribe model. The application level event is like a publish and subscribe model. So when a component fires an event, all the siblings can handle it, all the parents can handle it. Everyone in the, every component can handle it. Every component associated with you can handle it. Every component associated with you can handle it. Every component associated with you can handle it. Is that was clear for everyone? Right, Amma? What is the component level event? Your parent, 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 parent. You can handle, your parent can handle, parent, parent. Always you can handle. Your parent, 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 and so on. Top the hierarchy level you can handle. When you say application level, siblings, parents. Siblings, parent. Siblings, parent. I hope you are good. Clear for everyone? Now, let us take an example. Now, let us move on to the example. Let me give a quick example. Now I have a page like this. I have a page 1. As I told you in the previous example, search. When you click on the search, this account data should be displayed. List of contacts should be displayed. Whichever the account we found, that account name should be displayed. That account contact should be displayed. When I enter the name, click on the search, that account name should be displayed. The record contact should be displayed. Okay. The practical example is, this is the practical example for this. This example will be going for tomorrow's class. Now, whichever the record I selected here, when I select this record, when I have a list of records like this, my requirement was like this. I have a list of record like this. Whichever the record is selected here, the record data should come on the left hand side. Whichever the record is selected here, the record data should come on the left hand side. So when I say list of records, now we are getting this contact like this. I am saying don't show the contact like this. Show me the list of contacts there. Whichever the contact is selected, their contact data should be displayed on the left hand side. Now, our requirement is, okay, practical requirement can be, list of accounts are displayed here. Whichever the account is selected, their account data, contact data should be displayed on the left hand side. In that example, its application level event will be suitable. Now, as we are taking a basic level example, I am giving the structure like this. Right, ma'am? Okay. Now, what is your requirement? You have a search form here. Based on the search form, you are going to give one or two parameters based on the search form. Go to the Apex class, find out what is the corresponding context, corresponding opportunities, and pass the data to this. I hope you are good with this. I hope you are good with this. Okay. Now let me build. Is the requirement is clear? I am going to create a search form. If account is formed, if account is found, get that account ID. If I pass this account ID to component 1, based on the account ID, it will get list of contacts. Based on this account ID, you will get list of opportunities. Now, just I want to say there are 3 components available. One component is search form. When I enter the data, one will show account data, second will show list of contacts, third will show list of opportunities. Hope you got my point.
Satish, if you click on the first component, if I take any account on the first component, is it going to open in the same page it's going to open in the different tab?
I'm trying to explain right now. That's what I'm trying to explain. Okay. Right. Now, this was the example I was trying to explain. Right. So let us build this example, see how it is going to be handled. First, I'll try with the building. So instead of oral explanation, let us get on to the example and see practically what is happening here. First, I have event example. Now, I'm getting here. If okay, let's take a single line, AC CID. Basically, when I give a name and industry, it's going to find out an account and give you. There is a possibility of getting more than one account. So that's why I'm taking only the first account ID as the result. Okay. So list of account, accounts equal to name, phone, industry. This is how I wrote. The next one I have. Now, public string. Get contacts. Hosting. Where? What are you doing? Now here I gave, there is a possibility if accounts dot size equal to 0, right? So what we are going to give, list of accounts, contacts. Similarly, we're going to the next one, right? Now whatever the account data you entered, with that account data there may be a account, may not be an account. When there is an account, get only fetch the contacts. When there is no account, there is no use of fetching the contacts. No, so I can avoid the functionality. So what was this story? Opportunities. Opportunity. This is how I am taking it. Now, where's the bug here? Here.
From opportunity.
Look at this. Now, you are enabled. So what was the first context? Based on the data what I entered, it is getting the corresponding. Based on the data what I entered, it is going to get the corresponding account ID. Whatever the account ID I got, I am going to return you. If it is found, okay, ID I am going to give. If it is not found, I am going to return error. If I call, if I pass account ID, it give you list of contact. If I pass account ID, it give you list of opportunities. Okay, when if account ID is found. When account ID is found, right? When account ID is found, then run the operation. So what I was trying to do now, create event. Ira. Name equal to this is the event. Event name is account app event. Then component account jail search. This component is going to create a search. Controller equal to event. Now what it is doing? Ura attribute name equal to type equal to Ura. Draw Easter event equal to what? Type equal to what is the event name? Account app. Then I was giving let me give value equal to v dot whatever the name I am entering, I was given here. Value equal to button label equal to this is what I get. Okay, now I'm giving controller. What is the name of the controller we had? Account. Where was that? Line number 4, 6, value equal to v dot acc event name, we missed out c, okay. Action, it was an action I given button, it should be on click, on click action. Okay. When you click on that, we have a search. When you click on a search, what is happening? Where name equal to component dot get v dot. What are you trying to get? Name of an account. Where industry equal to component dot get v dot. Then we are trying to create where action equal to component dot get c dot. What is the name of the method we have? Action dot ACC name industry. This how we want. Account name, account industry. Then what was that? Action dot set callback. Action dot set callback. When you say action dot set callback, what we are going to do? This comma function. Then where state equal to response dot get state. If state equal to where result equal to response dot right. Now I'm giving if result equal to result not equal to error, then I'm going to call event. What do you call the event? Where event equal to dollar a dot get e dot c colon. What is the event name? Account app. So I'm firing the event only if there is an account ID. We are firing the event only when there is a account ID. When it is not error, because I told if the account is not found, then I ask you to give a error. When it is not error, we are going to do this. So before we are firing, what I want to do? Event dot set params. Then I'm going to give we are passing the parameter. Now what was that? When you click on the button, it is going to the Apex class, searching is there any account record. If account record is found, then only remaining two components will fire. Otherwise, stop firing. Now if I build everything in a single component, what happened? Now, why should I load the remaining two components? Why should I load the remaining two components? Why should I load remaining two components when ID is not there? When ID is not there, why should I load the component? Are you getting my point here? Why should I load the component when there is no ID? So here I was giving it. Then go to this. Fine. This is the parent component. First I will try to, this is done from here and close this. Then change to account child contacts. In the child contacts, what it is trying to do? Do you remember the data table program? If you remember, I'll copy paste. Do you remember that? Everyone? Okay. So let me copy paste the program. I will data table. Right. If you remember, I'll paste it. Otherwise, I'll write it. Everyone is good with this? Right. Now, what was the story here? Now, you're a handler. Name is not mandatory for us. Value is not mandatory for us. Here I need to give event C colon account. Right. You're a handler. Event account app event. When this is handling, what is the action you are going to get? Call contacts. Call contacts. Go to the controller. Go to the controller. Then in the controller, what we are supposed to do? This is a small program to specify the columns. Again, typing this will be more. Okay. Now, I think all the fields are different. I was supposed to type it again. So, what are the fields I fetched? Last name, first name, phone, email. Now, why we are taking this all stuff? Whichever the fields you want to display, you have to specify the label name of the field and a field name. Give me. This is the first story. Here we are supposed to give component dot set. Let me cross check. Okay. Then what it is supposed to do? Get all the list of contacts. How will you pass the list of contacts? Var action equal to component dot c dot action dot. What is the param? What is the param we have to pass? ID we have to pass. How will you get the ID? Whatever the event has fired, okay, now I want to get the ID from the event. Event is, okay, when you fire an application event, you are setting the ID of the account, right? When you are firing an application, when you are filing an application event, you are passing the ID of an account. So I want to capture that. How do you capture that? Where ACCID equal to given dot get from the passes.
Satish, if you are having multiple handlers or if you are handling multiple events, do we need to specify from which event the account ID is coming from?
Yeah, obviously. See, if you want to define three methods, three events, every three events should have three different names, no?
No, the variable name, account ID, line number 10, you said get palm.
Now, if there are three events, at a time three events will not fire, right?
Yes, okay.
Only one event will fire.
Okay, thank you.
The A dot and Q. We can also get the event name. We can find the event name and handle it. That is also one of the options. You can use the event name and find out. Hold back. Then where state equal to response dot get state. Return the value. Now we are going to say component dot set dot what was that? So it is setting the values of a columns, this is setting the value of a data. If the flag equal to true, then only it will be displayed. If the flag equal to false, it will not display. So what I'm going to do, if it is success, then I'm going to say component dot set without flag. Is that was clear? Right. When you wrote a SQL query, get the data and display the list of contacts. Now when the flag equal to true, this component will be displayed. I gave URI if this data will be displayed. I gave URI if this data will be displayed. Same concept, only the difference is instead of contact, it should be operation. Instead of contact, it should be operation. So what I'm going to do, lightning component. Same story. Replace it. Same information. Only the event name is, was that get opti. Okay. Right. Then create a controller. The controller, same JavaScript phone, only the name of the method is going to change. It is called contacts method, we have to call operators method. Instead of get contacts, we have to call get. Instead of get contacts, we have to call get opti. Then the changes are going to be name, stage name, close date. Now, so here we had a apart from that, any change? Come again? Which one, Amma? Call Line number two. Okay. Madan me. I give call opti. Okay. Because functionality is the same, I just replicated, only the method name is changed. Okay. Can I avoid this? Can I give this one as a helper method now? Why did I copy paste twice? I might have defined a helper method simply with one parameter, name of the object, name of the method name. I might have avoided it, right? Okay. Look at the format. We are defining call opti. We are defining call context. So I'll make a primary component. Now what we have? Child search. One. Child context. Child operation. All these three should be merged in a parent component. Account. Here, we are going to define this. Shall we go with writing layout? So we had a component. Do you remember the component called layout and layout item? What is the maximum size we have? We have maximum size of 12. Layout within the layout, we have a layout item. Just copy paste the components and give it. Do you remember that? Or should I type it? Remember? So we have a layout. In the first layout item, we are using C colon account. Then again, the second one we have. We had C colon account child. Then I had one more element called lightning. Size. So I can give so what was that new component? Check out the spelling somewhere, account, child, search. Account, child, contacts. Account, child. I give here, TI. So get on to the story. This is the parent component. So this should be invoked within the application. Lighting application. So we are going to use this lighting application. Then view this how we got it. So let's have a preview.
Hello Satish.
Wait Amma, let me finish off. Now what we got here, name, industry, and we got the remaining two components are not displayed because I told display that only when it is when flag equal to true. Then let me take any one of the account which have a list of contacts and opportunities. Let me search for this account. Account has one contact, three opportunities. Okay. Now I'll search for this. What is the industry it has got? Biotechnology. I can still extend it. I can say if an industry is, if account name is not equal to null, industry is not equal to null, you can make a dynamic sub query. All this stuff you can do it in the FX programming. Search. When you're making a search, let us see, some event is not fired.
In the search, you have given wrongly account ID instead of giving response. That's what I'm trying to tell you.
Okay, let me check out. Search. I given, what is the event?
Set parameters.
ACCID. They given ACCID. Now, whatever the result you have given, result is supposed to be result. Okay, thank you. Now go back to the application. Have a preview of this. Again, search. Still there is a bug. Let me check out what is the maximum track size exceeded. Okay. Let me move on. Let me cross check.
You did not save it.
It is saved up. Save. Okay. Now let us move on to the structure here. Let me give what is the value of result I got here. Now I need to look at the console.log.
Okay. So in the child search component, Satish, you didn't give the ID in the account list query.
Let me check out. Let me check one by one. Now, this you have taken. Let me go to the components, child components, controller. I gave last name, first name, phone, email. Then I told get the ACCID. What was the element I have given here? ACCID. Go back to this. Right. So now I will try to just display this data. Some stack size error we are getting. Let me check out this. Again, I'm going to give. Console.log. Let me cross check one more time the account class, what I given. Size I have taken, if size equal to 0, ACCID equal to error. If size is not 0, take the first one. Or size only one account we are going to give.
The ID is not selected, line number 5.
Line number 5.
ID is not selected.
It is a SQL query, right? So by default, okay. ID is to be fetched.
Okay.
Right. By default, irrespective of ID, okay, right. You know, we modified. So let me go back and check out what is the third component. So whether data is passed properly or not, what was that? We don't need this. Okay. We are the opportunity. Let me check the control once again. I'm giving again here console.log.
One bit. Stack size is the same as Apex heap error. Heap size in the Visual Force page.
Yeah. Let me first set that. See, let me fix it line by line. We'll know. Okay, come to know. If everybody is giving one line, so obviously we'll end up moving. Just first let us put all the console. Let us see where the bug is coming up, then we'll fix it up. Okay. Right, we had a, so what is the solution we had here? Console.log. Now it is supposed to be get params, right? Set params, okay. Console.log, okay. Now it is, we are giving v dot okay, let me hold it. Let me make the first one application review. Point search. Now let me go to the console. Maximum stack size exceeded account jail search. Maximum stack size exceeded. So what was that? Basically, why the function was called so many times? Loop is running here. Am I right? The functionality issue was the loop was running. So the call went inside the loop. So let me cross it. What made it to go like a loop? Functionality is running, but it is running like a loop. If it is running like a loop, first let me remove this event. Account search. Account jail search. It registered an event, then on click, you're calling the search button, it is going to search and find the event. Jail component, URA handler, get the list of records. Basically, it is running like a loop. Why it was getting into a loop? What is the function? Account jail search, firing an event.
Satish.
1 minute, let me check. Just give
me the issue is for the class name also you have given search and the E. What are the controller name you have given search? So it's going to loop. Change any one of the name. Then it will not go to through loop. Search controller.
But it is going to call, it is going to be calling the JavaScript function, not the Apex class name, right? You know, like, let me check out. Let me take your suggestion. Go back again. Yeah, so you are right. So what happened here? When I enter the data, we are getting the contact, we are getting the list of components. So this component has, okay, let me discuss the output, then I'll tell you what are the errors I imported, what I fixed. Okay, now first, when I click on the search, what are you getting here? This data I have captured, I made a call to Apex class. I found, is there any data in the account with the same name? If data was there, get the ID. Now get the ID, fire the event. When you fire the event, who are the people who are handling it? Now we have component, jail component 1 and jail component 2. There are 3 siblings. Account search, contacts, opportunity. Account search, contact, opportunity. Account search, contacts, opportunity. Now whatever the account ID we got, put them in the event, fire the event. So who is going to subscribe the event? Now there are 2 people who are subscribing. Contacts people and opportunity. What the contact is trying to take? The contact component is going to take the ID, make a call to Apex class. When event is going to pass account ID. Until you pass the account ID, I don't need, I mean, okay, no need to search for contacts and opportunity. when I search, if account ID is fired, automatically it has to fetch the contacts and opportunity. When it has to fetch the contacts and opportunity, only when the account is fired. I don't want to make a single call and say, get all the data. Now, you can implement the same concept without events. How can I do that? Click on a search. Okay, go to Apex class, put the data in a wrapper class. In the wrapper class, what data you are going to put? Account ACC, list of contacts, list of opportunity. Then when you click on a button, go to Apex class, write a SQL query, check if account ID is found. Yes, found, get the contacts and opportunity, put them in a wrapper, display the wrapper. Wrapper will display all the list of data. This entire thing I am trying to achieve within a single line. Then I have to write a logic whether wrapper ID, account ID is there or not. If account ID is there, then check whether contacts are there or not. If contacts are there, then opportunity is there or not. Instead of putting everything in a single wrapper class, I was taking them like a multiple components. I am handling this data with the events. So what happened? When I enter the name and industry, when you click on the search, it is going to the component one. Okay, going to the Apex class, searching for the ID of the account. If account ID is found, give me the account ID. Based on this account ID, one component is fetching the contacts, another component is fetching the opportunities. Okay, then display the data. I hope you are good with this. Basically, how many components are there? Three components wrapped under one parent component. So the data in the first component is transferred to second component, third component. Is that was clear for everyone? Is that was clear for everyone? Okay. Now, the mistakes I have made here. First, I got heap size. When we found a heap size, then we understood that it's a loop is running. Loop is running. Then in the loop is running, then we search for the option. In the action I gave, on click. On click, I gave search, and Apex class method also we gave search. Because obviously it went to loop, we renamed this data as search data. So the loop is stopped. We can, okay, we lost that error called heap size. So initially we got the heap size. Why the heap size? It went to loop. So it is fetching the data number of times. We got that error called heap size. So when you observe that, as somebody suggested, there was a search data, name of the JavaScript function I gave as a search, name of the Apex class method also we gave as a search. So it was going to the loop. So we equified it as search data, the loop stopped and we got the data. Right? Apart from that, there is some spelling mistakes, typo errors. I hope you got the concept. You got the concept. So what is an application level event? What is an application level event? When an event is fired, it can be handled by siblings. When the event is fired, it can be handled by siblings. I hope you are good. Okay. Now, shall we try one example on the same story? Everyone has followed this example. Let us try one basic example from your end. Look at the story. The same one, but the point here is, look at the point. I have the same story, slightly modified. Account should be created. After account is created, I have to get or else. When I click on save, when a contact was saved, then it has to show me the data here. name. Last name. You have to show the data of. This is the story. First, I am going to enter the account data. Click on save. If account was successfully saved, then the contact data should be displayed here. Then it has to give me a scope of creating a contact. When the contact was saved, then it has given me a scope of creating a. It has given me a scope of creating a, okay, displaying a account data and contact data. So how will you achieve this? After account is saved successfully, contact creation should come. After contact creation is successful, then I have to get a data like name, phone number, first name, last name. I hope you got the story, right? So how will you achieve it? Now tell me first, how many FX classes you are going to create? One is to create an account, return the ID of the account. Second one is to create contact, return the ID of the contact. Now we got account ID, we got contact ID. We got account ID, we got contact ID. Now when you pass this account ID and contact ID to third one, when you pass the account ID and contact ID to third one, now it has to write a SQL query, get the account data, contact data and display. I hope you are good with this. When account is inserted, this is the story what should happen. So account insert, contact creation. Contact creation completed, display of the data. I hope you are good. I hope you are good. Right. Start creating the program. First go with the creation of account. Second one is creation of contact. Third one is fetching the account data, contact data. I felt people already by now know the topics what we covered. So we're just getting into the example. Right. First, create. Now they should have two events. It's not one event. I am taking here two events. I want to take two events, two different application events. Okay. This example consists of two different application events. Okay. First, create a class with these two methods. Let us do step by step. First one is going to take account as a parameter, insert the account, and then account ID. Return account ID. Second one is going to take a contact as parameter and return contact ID. If it is failed, error. First part of the story. The same story again.
Satish, you did already mention that for component level events, the name plays a important role, whereas application events, the name doesn't play an important role. Can you just please tell us one more time why is that?
See, the syntax of invoking the method is based on the event. Okay. Now the syntax of invoking the event is based on the name for component. For the application, it's not that there is no omit, because multiple components can fire multiple events. So based on the event directly, it will be recognized. Now every sibling may have, when I'm creating an event for me, my component can have the same name as the event what the second component is creating. Then there's a conflict. There's a reason we are directly invoking with. Now if it is a parent child, all of there is a dependency on it. When you're taking a sibling separately, if I give the same name, there will be conflict. So application level events are invoked based on the event name directly. Right. There's no specific reason which I read from that. For what I understood from examples what we have done to avoid the conflict in the application level, because sibling can handle it, child can handle it, parent can handle it, there may be a possibility of the same name encountered. But whereas in the component level event, it is a hierarchy structure. In the hierarchy, anywhere it founds duplicate, it throws an error message for you. That's what I understood from the structure of the example I have seen, right?
Okay, thank you.
So, ECC. Right. Then I created a class which takes an account and return the ID of the account or error message. There is another method which takes a contact and account ID, create a new contact for an account, new contact for an account, then the contact ID. And going to return the contact ID. Then let us build the first component. The class is clear, boss. Okay. Now let us build the first component. The first component is create this first component. Name, phone, industry, SIG. Create the first component. All of you create the first component. Build the first component. The first component what we created. Controller. So did we create an event first? We are supposed to create an event. One event. Okay. First, I'm creating a component. Then we'll just add up the events. Attribute. Name. Name. Type. Default right. So we are going to create card lightning output.
Is v dot Satish v dot acc dot
yes 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 so next we had a button here right now what you are supposed to do, when you click on that, show method is going to fire. Then we want an event to be fired. I want an event to be fired. That event has to return. That event has to go with. That event has to go with. Okay, the event should go with. Create an account. If account was created successfully, I'll modify it. Okay. The account should be created successfully. If account is created successfully, I want event to be fired. So what is the event I have here? Account create event. Right. Now, this event should fire. We call this, call the method called show. In the show method, you have to invoke the Apex class method. When you call the Apex class method, if account was successfully created, get the result. If result is not equal to error, fire the event. Okay. Write the code. Write the code of the controller. Can you try this from your end? We'll continue in the next session. Okay. We'll be just winding up the session. We'll continue.